Hello, my name is Gunter Weser from GWJ Technology Germany. Today I will give you an example in our system calculation how you can model a simple planetary gear stage in where the planet pin is mounted in the planet carrier. This is only a simple example to show you how you can model this, starting from a white paper. But you can use also a template. This would be also available. But this video tutorial should be show you how you can do this step by step. The system manager is our system environment that works together with the single calculation modules of our web-based calculations of the e-assistant and also with our single calculation modules of our desktop application TPK, because both are identical, but the e-assistant is web-based and the TPK is a classical desktop application. Now I want to move to the system environment, to our system manager, as an extension to the e-assistant or TPK. Here in the system manager we have a lot of possibilities for the calculation of multi-shaft systems or different kind of gearboxes, and for planet carriers, for planet gearboxes. We have a lot of different possibilities to model different kind of planet gearboxes. The system manager is a real multi-shaft system calculation. So in the background we have a multi-shaft FEM model, and the shafts are coupled with nonlinear couple annealing elements, and these are the gears. Here we have also on the settings, a lot of different settings and applications and so on. But for this, I don't want to go in detail in these options. And also, I don't want to go in a lot of other possibilities that you have in this system environment. I focus only of how you can model a simple planet carrier stage, planet gear stage, with a planet pin is mounted in the planet carrier. For this, we start here in the navigation tree, and on the item shafts, we select shafts and we add at first a group. And this group should be our main group, and so I rename this. I go to this register card and I input here main group. And this main group should have three shafts. The first shaft is already existing, and I add with the right mouse button a second shaft and a third shaft. And the first shaft should be our sun. The second shaft should be our annulus, and the third shaft should be our planet carrier. In this example, the planet carrier is a very simple shaft, but we have also the possibility to work with 3D elastic parts. That means you can import a step model, or you can generate a parametric model of a planet carrier, so we can work with a real geometry, and you can consider also the deformation of a planet carrier regarding to the load distribution for the phase width and so on. Yeah. And now I will input also the speed for the sun, and the speed for the sun is, for example, 1500 RPMs. And the geometry is here. I insert a simple geometry. I can do this more in detail, of course, but for this example I work with very simple geometry. So I input a length for the shaft of 70 millimeters, and a diameter of 20 millimeters. And here we go to the loading elements, and we insert now a loading element with this plus button here, and we select the kind of loading, and this is a coupling at first, and this is our input coupling, and the positioning is at 5 and the width is 10 millimeters. So that means the position is every time the middle of the element, so here at X is 5 millimeters and the width is 10 millimeters. And now I insert my input torque, for example 100 newton meters. I can switch also the unit if I need this, but now I would like to work with newton meters. And I can work also with plus or minus for the torque, or I can change the direction of the torque to shaft is driven or shaft is driving. Here I will use shaft is driven. Now I input another coupling, another loading element, and this is a cylindrical gear, and this is our sun, and we put it on position 60, and the phase width should be 20, and the number of teeth, for example, should be 18, and module 2, and all over we can specify later. And we need also some supports or constraints, and so I go to the supports. I use this plus button to insert a simple support, and the name of this should be the motor support. That means this is a connection to the motor or something else. And this support is on position X 0, and it's supported radially and also in both axial directions. Now with this, the geometry of the sun is finished. Now we go to the analysis, and here we input also the geometry, or at first we go to general, of course. We go to the speed. We open the speed and we say we want to work with a fixed annulus. That means the speed is 0. And we go to the geometry and we insert here the geometry. For example, the length is 25 and the diameter is, the length is the 20 for the annulus and the diameter is 160. And the inner geometry is here 155, for example. Yeah. And now I can change the axial position in this group of this shaft. So for this, I go back to the general and I insert here the X position, and this should be 50, for example. And now we see we have the same axial position for the annulus and for the sun in this group. Okay. And now we need the loading, so we insert also a new loading element, and for this we use a cylindrical gear, and this is our annulus on position 10, phase width 20, and for the number of teeth we use minus because it's the internal gearing, so minus 70 teeth and module 2, for example. And we go to the supports to fix the annulus regarding to the environment with this plus button, and this is our, I will say, housing, for example, in the middle of this, so position 10, and the shaft is also supported against tilting and against torsion, so it's really fixed to the environment. Yeah, and now we are finished also with the annulus, and now we go to the planet carrier. And for the planet carrier, we go to the geometry, and we insert here a simple geometry like 25 for the first segment with diameter of 60. And another shaft segment with length of 60 and diameter of 100, and another shaft segment with length 30 and outside diameter also 60 again. So it's a very simple thing. And now we need also a little bit internal geometry. So we go on this right side, insert an inner geometry element with a length of 35 and a diameter of 50. And another element with length of 40 and internal diameter should be 85. And another element with this 45, for example, and diameter 50 again. So we see here the length of the outer geometry is 120 millimeters, and for the internal geometry is also 120 millimeters. So it's fine. And now we would like to move this also in the axial position a little bit. So we go to the general again, insert here axial position of 10. And so, yeah, it's okay. Or a 5. No, I will work with 10. Yeah, okay. And no, with 5, sorry. Yeah, so it looks better. Okay, and for the planet carrier, we need also a support or a constraint, and this should be our output coupling. And for this, I insert a constraint with a kind of constraint is coupling for reaction torque. And this is our output. At position 104, I will move this a little bit manually. So with the shift button and left mouse button, I can move this, of course. And now it's finished. And I will insert also some bearings. So I insert a support and select roller bearing on this. And I go to this plus button here. And here we can select different manufacturers, of course. Yeah. And now I will select a bearing. Yeah, like like this, for example, or I can use a smaller one. Yeah, I take this. Okay. Oh, I think I can work with a larger, sorry. So I will select a larger. Yeah, it's a little bit larger. It doesn't matter. And this is bearing 1, for example, and I insert another bearing. This is bearing 2, and I move this to the other shaft. So, okay, yeah, and this bearing is I remove this a little bit, and this is fixed, and the other is free for this, yeah. So now we have here a small, it's connected to the outer ring, of course, to the housing, and the same also to the housing, but looks fine. And we go and here, okay, why he has this stupid geometry. I will select this again. Okay, now we have the correct geometry, yeah. Sorry. Yeah. Okay, and now we have also the bearing finished here for the planet carrier, and the coupling for reaction torque for the output. And now we need, of course, our planets. And for this, we're coming now to the important step. We have to insert a new group, but not a normal group. We have to insert a planetary group. So we add a planetary group, and this planetary group has different properties. So I go to this group with this register card here, and this is my PL group, and here I can specify the number of planets. So I input here a number of planets of 3, because on the sun we have only one support on one side, and on the other side the sun should be supported by the planets, so I need at minimum a number of planets of 3. And we want to insert here also some more shafts in the planet group. I add a shaft, and I add another shaft, and another shaft. So we have 3 shafts here. And the first shaft is our pin with a simple geometry, like this. So 20 as length for the first segment, and diameter 20. And the second segment also 20 millimeters long, and the diameter is 40, and the last is 20 millimeters long and also diameter 20 again. And now we go to the loading here, and we insert also a loading element again with this plus button, and we say a cylindrical gear, and this is our planet. And we set the planet on position 30 and phase with 20 again. And number of teeth should be maybe 25, and a module of 2 again. Okay. And before I go forward to the bearings, because we would like to mount the pin in the planet carrier, I need some help shafts. So I go to this shaft, I go to the general, and I say this is a part of my planet carrier, so I name this PLC left, and on the other side PLC right. So PLC left, we input a geometry with a length of 15 and a diameter of 50, and the inner geometry also 15 length and the diameter of 42, for example. And we go to the supports, and we connect this to the planet carrier now. So we insert here a new constraint as a planet planetary support. So we say PLC support left in the middle of this, for example, and we connect this to the planet carrier, and fixed in, so also against tilting and against torsion. Okay, and we do now the same with the PLC right, so with our help shaft, so we insert the geometry with 15 and 50 here, and the internal geometry also with 15 and 42, for example, and we move this to position 45, so it's at the end of the pin. And we insert also a support with this plus button, and this is also a PLC support right on the same position, and it's of course connected to the planet carrier and supported against tilting and torsion. Yeah. And now we can go, so these are parts, these help shafts are parts of our planet carrier now. We are directly connected to this, with this constraint here. And now we can go back to the pin, and we can support our bearings. We can insert our bearings here with this plus button, and we select roller bearing, and this is our planet bearing one. And we select this from the database. Here we can select the different kind of bearings. But in this case, I will use simple deep groove ball bearings, for example, and we select this here from this database. And I select, for example, this FEG bearing, okay. And positioning directly in the middle. And now I do this with the other. And move this also to this. Okay, and now I have selected the shaft is connected to the inner ring, and the outer ring is connected to PLC right, and here to PLC left. Okay, and yeah, this is only supported on one, for example. Okay, and now we are finished also with this. And now we can define our gear connections. So we go to the gear connections, to the cylindrical gear pairs, we insert a gear connection, and this is the sun together with the pin and the planet, and this should be blue. And here we can select the connected calculation software, should be the E-Assistant or the TPK, depending on our configuration. This calls the single calculation module directly in the background, and so it's used here. In this case, we use the E-Assistant. And now we define the second gear pair, and this is the planet together with the annulus. On the basis of these two cylindrical gear pairs, we define the planetary gear set. So we insert also here a connection, and this is sun and planet and annulus. And now we need also a positioning rule. So we go to the positioning, insert one positioning rule, go to this, and select here group according gear pair. And we would like to make the positioning of a planet group relative to the main group. So we use here the planet group with the gear pair sun and planet. And the axial position is zero. That means the middle of the face with, of the sun is in contact with the middle of the faces of a planet, for example. Yeah. And so now we are finished with this. And we see now all on the right position here. Okay, this looks good. And I check the sun again. We have here also the loading and the input. That's okay. And now I can say run. And now it's finished. And we can check also the animation. We see, yes, the annulus is fixed. The sun is driven, and here the output is on the planet carrier. Yeah, we can check this also with the power flow, and you see here the power goes through the sun, over the planets and the annulus, over the, and here over the pins to the planet carrier, and from the planet carrier here to the output. Okay. After the modeling and the first calculation, we can define now the gearing in detail, and for this we can call the detailed planetary gear calculation. And so we will jump now in the single calculation module for the planet gear stages. So we go here in the navigation tree for the gear connections here to Sun, planet, planet, annulus, and to, and we call now the phone click here the single calculation module for planetary gear stages of the E-system or the TPK. And now we can change here also the configurations, because here we see we have no symmetric arrangement of the planets, for example. So we would like to change the number of planets, the number of T for the planet. And we would like to change also the number of T for the sun, like this. And we change the working center distance also a little bit, like this. And now we can go to the geometry, and we can select here the splitting forward profile shift coefficient with this calculation button to balance specific sliding, for example, for the sun and planet. Okay. And here we can insert also a maximum outside diameter, and for the load capacity calculation, okay, we have already the ISO, and we would work with the other. This should be enough. And if I go back to the system and I calculate again, I see now also the arrangement of the planets, of course, here is symmetric. And here in the gear connections, I see also the safeties for the sun, for the planet, and for the annulus, for the root, and also for the flanks, of course. And now we could also activate the load spectrum calculation. For example, for this we can go to the system. We can activate here the load spectrum. Now we have a new entry here, new item in the navigation tree, and here we can work with this examples. This is very easy, the input speed for the sun, and for the input torque, for example. Yeah, you can specify the wished values here according to the right mouse button, and you can say general comment, for example, and you can say here this is case one, and here we have case two. And now we can say run only with case two, and we go back to the gear connections and we calculate again, and we see this, these are the changed safeties for case two, for example. Yeah. Okay, this was a short overview or a short tutorial how you can model a simple planetary gear stage where the planet pin is are mounted in the planet carrier. And this is not really a practical example, it's only to show you how you can do this. For other functionalities, we have also some more video tutorials, of course, or if you have some questions or do you need more information, please contact us. Your feedback is also welcome. You can contact us via our website or via email or telephone. You're really welcome. So for today, I thank you for your time, and I hope we can see us again next time. Thanks and bye-bye.